one radio in the whole house. So we'll gather around that radio, listen. Independence Day was a big event. Everybody's gathering, celebrating. The another one I remember very vividly, suddenly the whole house was shut in silence. Gandhiji was assassinated. And my father, who is a staunch Muslim leader, he's a very religious man. He genuinely supported the cause of Pakistan. And standing before the radio and crying. So there's the memory that I can share. In the post-war, post-liberation war, everything was in tatters, everything was at shambles. Classes don't held, exams don't take place because young people are still coming back from the battlefields with the guns still in their control, still they have their revolvers in their positions. So hardly anybody cared for anything, teachers, schools, classes, exams, and so on. So I was trying to bring some, restore some discipline in the education that I'm supposed to impart. But as we still, we are hoping that something exciting will come out of all this devastations and everything. Economic situation, instead of improving, started sliding down very sharply. By 1974, it became a famine. So ended up with a famine, people dying. So all your dreams turn into nightmare. That was a nightmare we are in. Then the offshoot of that, I became very upset with the subject that I teach, economics. I said economics is a make-believe story. It has no muscle, no kind of a content in it, which will be used to overcome, help people overcome their hunger and so on. It's a big talk, no thing, nothing in the world. So as I was feeling, I thought I was totally useless for a person. I cannot help people. Subject I learn is a useless subject. It doesn't give me any tools, any equipment to do at least one thing to help people. I could cross the boundary of the university, which is a brand new, beautiful campus, like any other campus anywhere in the world. But the moment you step outside the boundary, it's a traditional 1,000-year-old village. So nothing changed. It's worse because of the liberation war and all the turmoil that it's caused. So I would go in the village and spend time with me, hours and hours talking to people. My intention was to see if I can find an opportunity to make myself useful to at least to one person for one tiny thing for that day. If I could find something like that, I feel very happy that day that I've done something for somebody. So one desperate thought came to my mind, forget it. Why don't I lend the money myself? If I lend the money, the person is protected. He or she doesn't have to go to the loan shark. And I have saved one person from loan shark. And the money involved is so small. The system that we built for banking is the reverse of the system that exists. We have reversed everything they do. They go to the rich, we go to poor. They go to men, we go to women. They go to city, we go to rural village. They ask for collateral, we dismiss collateral. In our entire banking system, there is no collateral. The word trust never meant anything to them. Everything banks do is based on distrust. They bring their lawyer in. So we defied all those rules and created. So this is one, and we're focused on poverty, how to address the poverty issue, help them become entrepreneurs so that they can grow by themselves. And I argue that the finance is the oxygen for people. It's for entrepreneurial ability to come out. Poverty is not created by poor people. Poverty is created by the system that we built. So we have to address the system, not the people. So fix the system. Then I saw it's not only the poverty. It's created lots of other damages to the human being, the same system that we're talking about. So I was talking against the entire system, not just one piece or the other piece. I said, look at proof. That if you look at the report card of the entire functioning of the system, is a terrible report card you get. It's a report card of global warming. Yeah. We are going to be extinct because of that. I said, what the whole system has done to us is to bring human being at a stage where we become the most endangered species on this planet. We don't have much time left. And they say, you call it a system which brings it here? You talk about the violence. It is a systemic violence. Violence is built in. You punish people. All the wealth of the world is concentrated in few hands. 1%, 1% of the global population own 99% of the wealth of the entire population. So remaining 99% of the population has to do with 1% of the wealth. What kind of economics is that? I tell the young people everywhere in the world that you are a privileged young people. You are very fortunate young people because you are the most powerful generation in human history. You have the power to change the world. So don't look for little things to do, because you alone can change the world. It's your creative power. It's your thinking power, imagination power that will make it happen. You have to build a completely new world. This world is gone, finished. This civilization is the way on the way out. You have to make the step of beginning of new civilization to create a new world. And I define it in my way. I said this would be a world of three zeros. Zero net carbon emission, and zero wealth concentration, and zero unemployment. Because artificial intelligence is coming to take away all our work, whatever we do, whether you're an entrepreneur, whether you're a worker, doesn't matter. Whether you're a singer, whether you're a professor, whether you're a journalist, all the work will be taken by artificial intelligence and will become garbage on this planet. We don't want to make it happen. You stop that. If you stop that, then we can survive. And not only survive, this is survival. You have to be the peak of your creativity and show what a beautiful world you can make, and you can make it. And nothing is impossible for human beings.